I know from living that if you quit whatever you're trying to accomplish, if you quit, whatever you were trying to accomplish can never happen. There's not even a remote possibility. If you quit, there is no chance of it popping back up again, coming back later. Quitting is guaranteed failure.
Only those that can see the invisible can do the impossible. You have to be able to see what doesn't exist in order to be able to pull off or achieve what in most people's minds seems to be impossible. Only those that can see the invisible, being able to see what's not there. What is your vision? What is your idea? What was that God-sent dream?
And so whatever the volcano is, you have the capacity to take that volcano on, the capacity to jump in it and find your true identity. Here's another thing that keeps a lot of people from taking on the volcanoes and jumping into the challenges that they're confronted with: the fear of making mistakes or not feeling good enough. Guess what? You're going to make some mistakes. You're going to make a lot of mistakes. Guy said this, and it's true. He said the person who's never made a mistake hasn't done anything.
Success and failure are generally slow processes. Either slowly building things up or gradually tearing them down. And that's why I say you've got to pay attention. You have to watch. You have to watch every single second, because those seconds, they turn into minutes, and minutes turn into hours, and hours turn into days, and days turn into years.
It doesn't change who I am. What I'm going through does not change who I am.
If you're going to make some mistakes, if you want to do something out here, you're going to fall flat on your face. You're going to be criticized when you come out into the arena called life. You're going to feel awkward and stupid and dumb sometimes. It goes with the territory.
Be relentless. You have to never let off the gas, never stop, never quit. Never allow anyone to talk you out of the dream, the vision, and ideas that God has sent you.
That second that just went by, that counted. And so did that second. And so did that one. And in those precious seconds, you were either building or you were decaying. You were either gaining ground or you were losing ground in that second.
Like, I believe in life, you got two separate people. You got champions, right? And they go through things in life that are self-inflicted. They bring it upon themselves, they get through it, they say, man, I got through it. And then you got warriors, right? They walk outside, the wind hits them, knocks them down, they pick up their stuff, they adjust, and they get moving, and they deal with the adversity that they didn't expect. They set their perspective right, and they figure out a way to embrace it and add value to every environment that they go into and every person's life that they come in contact with.
Trying, you're going to fail. But quitting, just stopping, that was the number one thing I understood. And then number two, you have to make sure that your dreams, your aspirations, and goals